so how do you even know if you have a parasite, right? Like, these are all things I just mentioned that can make you susceptible to having a parasite, but how do you know exactly if you have one? I'm gonna be touching on all of those things right now. Having a parasite is very similar to other digestive situations or diseases. Things like SIBO, leaky gut, IBS, IBD, and even candida, they have very similar symptoms. So you wanna know these few key differentiating factors that I'm about to discuss to give you a hint as to whether you do have a parasite or several parasites, if so. Number one, painful digestive disturbances. So having a parasite, it's robbing your body of nourishment. It's robbing you of the nourishment that your cells need to keep you thriving and keeping you energetic and feeling good, right? So you're going to have some type of digestive disturbance, whether it's stomach pain, maybe it's gas, it's bloating, and this is on a chronic level. So this is ongoing every day. For me, I have to tell you guys, in the mornings, I would always have stomach aches, and then, you know, I would start my day and I'd be fine. So, you know, it doesn't have to be every day. It doesn't have to be at the same time. Like for me, it could just be sporadic. Another thing for me was having bloating after having a large meal or just having a small meal. It could be just a little piece of fruit, I'd be bloated, you know? So these are the little things you have to pay attention to. Write down every single time in a little journal or on your phone when you get bloated. Is it after having fruit? Is it after having fried foods? Is it after having processed foods like chips, cookies, condiments, salad dressings, or is it just maybe the combination of foods, like having fruits on top of like a meal? You know, like think about those things and start to notice when you're experiencing these painful or even not so painful, but just digestive disturbances. And that will help you to figure out, do you have a parasite? Next, unexplainable weight loss. So again, going back to the fact that these parasites are robbing you of nourishment. If you're eating regular or even large portions of foods on a daily basis and you're still losing weight, that's a very good sign that you are experiencing an intestinal worm. Next, chronically soft stools or diarrhea. Basically, IBS symptoms. So IBS is irritable bowel syndrome, and it's one of those digestive diseases that basically wreak havoc on your bowels and any type of thing that has to do with your digestive system. So what happens in IBS is that when you eat food and that food goes through your system and it starts to digest, part of that food gets digested and the rest of it sits there in a partially digested form. That partially digested food gets added on to new food that you put into your stomach, because of course you're gonna eat another meal in maybe 3 or 4 hours, maybe 5 hours, and it mixes all together and it creates what we call ama in Ayurveda, or toxins. That toxin builds up in your system and it allows your bowel movements to have very foul smells. On top of that, it may allow your bowel movements to be soft, like diarrhea or even constipation. So what will happen with these IBS symptoms are you'll either have constipation or diarrhea or alternating situations. So sometimes diarrhea, sometimes constipation. That's a very good sign that you have a parasite. If you're having these IBS-like symptoms and you know for a fact that you do not have IBS. To know if you have a parasite for real, one thing you can do is take a home parasite stool test, or you can go into your doctor's office and you can have them do a blood test and test for parasites. This is not 100% guaranteed to let you know if you have a parasite, because parasites are very tricky. They can lodge in different parts of your body, different organs. And these tests that they're doing at the doctor's office or even the home stool test are actually testing for usually anywhere from 4 up to 13 types of worms. Now, if you have some other type of worm, by the way, there's millions of worms, or those worms are not in your colon or not coming from your colon, maybe it's lodged somewhere else in your tissues or in your organs, it's not going to detect it, right? So you can take this, you know, test, and I recommend everybody taking it. I'm actually going to be taking one myself, but you want to really focus on your gut feeling. If you feel in your gut that you have a parasite, you know, you're checking off the boxes and you're saying, okay, I'm having digestive disturbances constantly, I'm having IBS-like symptoms constantly, and I'm losing weight, then, you know, you might want to just say, hey, I have some type of worm, or I have some type of chronic digestive issue, and just go go right ahead and deal with that. If you want to use the home parasite stool test to figure out if you have a parasite or several parasites, I'm going to be linking a few of the options down below that I found. I'm going to be choosing from one of those myself. So definitely check them out. Get a home parasite stool test if you have suspicions. But besides that, it will not hurt to cleanse yourself at least once a year when it comes to just getting rid of any type of intestinal worm or any other type of digestive issue that you may be having, using what I'm about to be sharing with you next.